We're here with Larry Crane, who knows more about cars than most anybody I know. And he's a docent at the Mullen Museum. And what is this that you brought today?
It's a Peugeot Darlmat Cabriolet. Darlmat was the largest Peugeot dealer in France. He was in Paris. And his specialty was tuner Peugeots.
Whoa.
You order your family sedan from Darlmat and get an extra 20 horsepower. So a customer commissioned him to do a coach-built version of one of these cars, of a 302 series, and then the customer started lining up.
Wow.
They made around 20 of these Cabriolets. They made 30 Roadsters with removable windshields and 3 coupes. Now, the Roadsters went to Le Mans in 37 and finished second, third, fourth in class behind one of the aerodynamic Adlers. The Adlers made these beautiful streamlined coupes that were very fast. So Darlmat worked on his engine, got a little more horsepower out of his 2-liter, and went back, and two of his 3 cars failed. But the one car that finished was leading 2 Adlers, and it was exciting for him. So these were fast cars. They were real sports cars at the time.
Now, were they all? This one is by Portu.
It was designed by Georges Poulin, who was
Poulin.
Famous.
Okay.
Yes, Poulin, and built by Portu, who made a lot of coach-built cars with custom designers working with him. So,
wow.
And it's a, you know, it's a spectacular little car to drive. It's really impressive.
Oh, you've got to drive this.
It's the friendliest clutch I have had in a pre-select gearbox. It's really a lovely car to drive. Lago, Tony Lago, designed the Wilson Pre-Select in England before he came to Europe to take over Talbot.
Oh, I didn't realize
so
that.
There's a lot of history collected in all of these cars.
Well, people don't know, I mean, realize a lot of them don't. I mean, Peugeot had some amazing race cars.
And the double overhead cam was invented by Peugeot, 1912.
They clothed this to go with the horsepower, and they have a winner.
Exactly. This is a couture sports car, don't you see?
Oh, I like it. And this car is on display?
At the Mullen Automotive Museum. We describe it as an Art Deco museum with cars.
That's probably pretty
good. Lots of other stuff from the Art Deco era that Peter's involved with or enjoys. So we all get to win.
It's very kind of him to provide a place that let us enjoy it as well.
Right.
Indeed. Thank you, Larry.
Barnaby,
appreciate
thank you
it.
Very much. Enjoy your day.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the 11th annual La Jolla Concours d'Elegance. Best in show, the car that the judges have chosen to be the finest car at one of the finest concours in the world. 1937 Peugeot Darlmat Cabriolet, brought to us by Peter Mullen. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your best of show. Larry Crane, good friend. Now, Larry is accepting on behalf of the Peter Mullen Collection the beginning of a new tradition here, the winner's jacket. Larry, can you tell us a little bit about this car?
It's a Peugeot Darlmat coach-built car. Darlmat was the largest Peugeot dealer in France. His dealership was in Paris. And he was a specialist in doing high-performance tuning on your family car. A customer asked him to do a coach-built version for him. And, of course, the line formed immediately. So they made 20 of these Cabriolets, they made 30 Spiders, and they made 2 coupes. And the Roadster versions, in 1937, finished second, third, and fourth in class at Le Mans. They came back in 38 and won the class at Le Mans and beat the streamlined Adlers. This, incidentally, is one of the friendliest concours gatherings I've ever experienced. There's something about San Diego. I mean, it's an attitude-free zone in a concours d'elegance. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Michael Dorvier. It's been a pleasure to be here.
Thank you very much, Keith. And thanks to all of our sponsors, all of you out there that helped make this happen. There's over 200 volunteers on the field today, so I'd like for all of you to give a round of applause to all of our volunteers that are out here working. Thank you very much. See you next year.
This is it today for the Barnaby Chronicles in the beautiful cove in La Jolla, California, one of the most beautiful spots on the earth. And when you add all of my favorite cars here and the people, I'll tell you, you've just got a wonderful afternoon. So catch us next time on the Barnaby Chronicles.